Lots of people are really excited to see how Apple's gonna somehow make something more modular or more customizable. The Mac Pro, now officially titled the 2019 Mac Pro, because we know for sure it is not coming out this year, but it seems like there's already quite a lot of hype being built up for it. I, for one, find this particularly bizarre because I know that not that many people are actually gonna be buying it, but yet everyone loves to talk about it. Maybe it's because of the big failure, which was the last generation Mac Pro, still being sold for some reason. No Thunderbolt 3, no USB-C, and yet it's still available to purchase. Very confused by that. Still available and on display at Apple stores. Most people have just not been satisfied with it. Professionals didn't find it very customizable, and they felt the specs Apple offered with the Mac Pro just did not satisfy the majority of professionals' needs. Since then, Apple appears to have been redesigning kind of the professional lineup to just try to be a bit more useful and not so much based on profit. iMac Pro has had a ton of really good feedback. Even PC users out there can look at the parts they used in it and say, you know, building a PC with the same GPU and CPU and all that would be about that same price, if not a little bit more. So it'll be interesting to see how this new generation of Apple Mac professionals are able to pull off a new just tower design. So with today's, I want to focus on what I would like to see versus what I think is going to happen. And as we've seen in the past, those are rarely the same thing. What I think will happen and what I want to happen are two very separate things. So let's start with the wish list. What do I want to see? Personally, I don't think professionals care too much about the aesthetic or design of a machine that's basically going to be used as a tower. It's just a computer. There's no monitor hooked up to this. A lot of people are just going to hide it in their desks anyway. So for one, Apple, I think you don't really need to worry about the size of it. You don't need to make something smaller than the current Mac Pro. In fact, probably do the opposite. If you're able to make something that's fairly square and cubic, as long as it can be comfortably tucked under a desk or behind someone's workstation, I think they'll be okay with it. And they'll be okay with readily accessible ports. So my suggestion is to not go as big as you did with the earlier design square-ish more Mac Pro, but perhaps something like that. You know, that one had handles on it, it was made of aluminum, it had a very premium feel, but still very functional, whereas I think the more recent trash can designed Mac Pro, not too much functional. Yes, it looks cool, but professionals don't care about that kind of thing. They want it to work well. Looks aren't as big a deal, especially if you're not really intended to look at this thing ever. There's no display on it. So probably something that's just a little bit taller than that circular Mac Pro, but in more of a square design. That way, as I can get into our next subject, the modules can be a bit more customizable. There's spaces for RAM, there's spaces for processors, GPU, all that kind of stuff has breathing room, so you can still make a Mac Pro to your liking and have all of the exact parts you want in your machine. That way you're just not backed into a corner with your specs. Because personally, I think the fact that the starting price of a Mac Pro is $3,000, that comes with 256 gigs of storage? Yeah, no. Pretty dumb if you ask me, and if the point of the Mac Pro is to just kind of be a modular, customizable workstation, probably give some people some options. Probably people out there who just want terabytes and terabytes of not necessarily solid state options, but they just need it for deep storage and they want to have room for that in the machine. I'm hoping that Apple is able to go full on customizable with this machine so that if people want to use Radeon GPUs or Nvidia GPUs, they have that option. I know there's quite a lot of contracts with AMD and Apple that prevent them from being able to incorporate Nvidia, but I think if the user does it themselves, it's more okay. As we can see now, using external GPUs, Nvidia graphics cards are compatible with macOS. Maybe there's just some rule preventing Apple from shipping them with a Mac. Give the users that choice if your main goal here with the new Mac Pro is to be modular and customizable. With processors, it's kind of a wild card because we know that in just a couple years, Apple's gonna start switching to their own series of chips, and the idea of letting Mac users be able to take out their own CPU and replace it with a new one gets fishy really quickly. That seems like something Apple would not be okay with or not open to. But maybe if Apple's able to make some way to have their own socket within the motherboard that would allow them to attach future chips and current chips. Other companies like Intel or AMD could make their own processors that fit their own socket, and then all of these new modular Mac Pro users could have more options in terms of CPU as well. They want to go Intel, they want to go AMD, they have several different options to choose from. But hard to believe, especially given that if Apple has their own A series of chips or new series of chips that they start embedding into Macs, they likely wouldn't let their users change it. But iMac Pro surprised a lot of people with older legacy ports and fairly reasonable pricing. A lot of people thought the maxed out iMac Pro was gonna cost like 17 grand, more like 13, which was under what a lot of people were expecting. And since this Mac Pro will not be coming with a display, it'll likely start at a lower price than this current iMac Pro does, likely starting in the 3 to 4 grand range. So yes, of course, when I say modular, I do mean giving users all the possible configurations they could ask for. So let them change RAM, let them slide in more hard drives, whether they be solid state or Fusion hydrogen drive. Let them even swap out their own graphics cards if they desire to. I feel like Apple's primary source of revenue these days is through iPhones, Apple Watches, and iPads. And the Mac lineup is just because Apple knows they have a history of making workstation computers. That era of the Apple ecosystem is not really current anymore. They're not making a ton of money off of that section anymore. So they really should just make Macs that people are really demanding, given that most desktop users are dying out anyway. More people are switching to laptops, more people are switching to tablets. The amount of people who use desktops like I do, that's a shrinking number, which means that I don't think Apple has to be as stubborn or as direct about this is what we believe is the best way to do things. I think if you actually want sales to go up, or if you actually want people to be excited about the Pro class Macintosh workstations, Apple, you might as well just give them what they want, which is full customization. That's definitely how you've been hyping up this Mac Pro, so that's what I think you should do. And then lastly, let's talk about ports. iMac Pro allows for 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports, which is really good, but it's the same amount of Thunderbolt 3 ports you find on a 15-inch MacBook Pro or 13-inch MacBook Pro at that. So I feel like if you're getting something that is just a standalone power station, no all-in-one design, no attached monitor, you should probably get a benefit. My request is that they would add a 5th or possibly even 6th Thunderbolt 3 port to give the maximum amount of options. Because when you think about it, both the MacBook Pro and iMac Pro, they offer 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports for external monitors, external hard drives, external anything, because Thunderbolt 3 is extremely versatile. Difference is with the Mac Pro, it does not have a monitor attached to it, which I believe means that there will be extra GPU, extra processing power for you to hook up more monitors than just a standard 5K, or with the MacBook Pro, a 2K one. As in, technically, if I wanted to, I could have a 5 monitor setup with my iMac Pro, given it has a 5K monitor, it has 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports, I could hook up 2 on either side and have a crazy setup. I think it should make sense that the Mac Pro, given that's a tower, it should be able to do that or something better than that as well. So add a 5th or 6th Thunderbolt 3 port to give professionals even more options than before. Other than that, I think they should basically have all the same options that you have on the back. The 4 traditional USB ports, because this is professionals, even a headphone jack, I can get that one. A lot of people use these things as servers. So 10 gigabit Ethernet, an SD card slot. And Apple, because no one really cares about the design of this one, go ahead and put those ports on the front. People will thank you for it. You don't need to hide it all in the back so people can take cool pictures of what their new modular Mac Pro looks like. Let's focus on functionality. I also think, unlike the last Mac Pro, you should actually include a keyboard and mouse. That's something that I think everyone should just get when they buy a new Mac. They shouldn't have to buy that separately. Or perhaps include an HDMI cable or a USB-C cable if that's the future we're going for. Don't leave people so abandoned after spending $3,000 plus on a new Mac. The last Mac Pro literally came with that trash can and its power cable. No keyboard, no mouse. If you're spending that much money on a computer, I think it should come with that. So those are my wishes. Now, if we're getting into predictions, I don't think most of those things are gonna happen. Personally, I think people are building up in their minds what modular and customizable means. They're thinking this means that Apple's basically just making a macOS operated gaming PC, where you'll be able to open it up and change everything the way you want it and plug anything in just the way you like it, when in actuality, what I think modular Mac means is that you can change a couple of things. In other words, like, Apple charges $5,000 plus on all-in-ones that you really can't upgrade or customize anything on. Yes, you could go the difficult route and pop the display off and start swapping things out, but most people aren't gonna do that. So I think Apple's definition of modular changing means, like, you can change the RAM. Or maybe if we're lucky, you'll be able to expand your storage over time. That's what I think modular means for this new Mac Pro. It's not going to be as simple as just a tower that has a door that opens on it. Knowing this newer Apple, and knowing the Apple that designed the last Mac Pro, they would still consider that a massive improvement in giving users more options. Now, you can upgrade your RAM and storage. Isn't that modular? Isn't that what you wanted? And in actuality, people are going to be just as upset, and at the end of the day, the iMac Pro is still actually going to be a better buy, because you get so much in just a single purchase, opposed to paying less for something that doesn't come with as much, and you have to buy everything afterwards. Gotta buy extra storage, gotta buy an extra monitor, but gotta buy an extra keyboard and mouse. Whereas if you would've just caved and got an iMac Pro, you would've got all these things included with the purchase. Knowing the contracts Apple has with AMD and Radeon graphics cards, something tells me that your dream Mac of being able to put in your own GTX graphics cards is probably not gonna happen. That just doesn't feel like modern Apple. And acknowledge what I said at the beginning of this video of what I want to happen, that still holds up. I just don't really see it happening, knowing how Apple acts today. At best, this is going to be a very minute update. It's going to be a slight design change over the circular Mac Pro. They might make it a little bit more boxy. They're gonna update it with Thunderbolt 3, but honestly, I don't know why they haven't done that with the current one already. That desperately needs to have some more more modern ports on it. The fact that Apple still sells $3,000 plus Mac Pros with 6 Thunderbolt 2 ports. And yet with the MacBook lineup, we've been adopting Thunderbolt 3 for 2 years now. And by the time this new Mac Pro comes out, it will have been 3 years. That lineup is extremely dated, but you know what? Originally, when that Mac Pro came out, there wasn't an iMac Pro to compete with. I personally think we're getting into the era where Apple will just say, if you want a Mac with really good specs and it's an all-around good purchase, you better just get the iMac Pro. The modular Mac Pro is kind of there, but I don't think that many people are going to like it, because I think everyone's building up in their mind what they want it to be, and the fact that there's so much hype around it means it cannot live up to people's expectations. Just because Apple's saying they're working on some kind of modular Mac Pro does not mean they're going full customizable. To Apple, changing RAM and hard drives is customizable, given very little Macs can still do that, especially the newer ones. So I hate to give you sad news on what my predictions are, but you know what I hope happens, and maybe Apple could pull a wild card and surprise us and actually do what I was hoping for, but I'm keeping expectations low. Anyway, let me know what you think of the 2019 Mac Pro. What do you think it's gonna be, and what do you want it to be? Are those two separate things, or do you think that exactly what you want is going to happen is going to happen? I wish I had your optimism. Let me know in the comments below. And as a quick shout out, we're close to selecting the winner of our iPhone X case giveaway on Patreon. All you gotta donate is a buck or more, doesn't matter how much it is, but if you're part of our Patreon member list, you have the chance of winning some cool iPhone X merch. Let me reiterate, we're not giving away an iPhone X, I don't have that much money yet, but iPhone X's are expensive, you should protect them, try to get a case. This is your Apple Shapiro, and I will see you in the next one.